us and in ages to come. We give glory to your name, for you deserve it, Jehovah God. There is none like you. We thank you, Lord, for all that you have done. We bless your name for who you are, Jehovah God. And this morning we have just come to bless your name, to worship you, Jehovah God, to give you the glory, to give you all the honor. And we pray that, Jehovah God, even as we begin the service, that, Lord, you would honor us with your presence, that your spirit would come and minister to us, that, Lord, you would touch our hearts and you touch our minds. May you remove all distractions that may hinder us from listening to you, Jehovah God, this morning. We bless your name and we worship you. For all those who are watching this video, Jehovah God, may you meet them at their points of need. May they have an encounter with you this morning, Jehovah God. May you visit them, Jehovah God, wherever they may be. That, Lord, as we worship you this morning, Jehovah God, may you accept our offering of praise, Jehovah God. May we feel your presence, Jehovah God, and may you be with us, Jehovah God, to the glory and to the honor of your name. You deserve the glory, Lord. You deserve the honor. For your name
today. Although it's looking a little gloomy, we are all inside somewhere, so we are welcoming you to now the praise session. We are going to dance. I cannot see you, but the Holy Spirit is seeing you. That one, that person who's sitting down, stand up. That one who's lying in bed watching, just stand up. Just dance. It's just for a few minutes. We just want to, you know, this is just an example of how we will be praising and dancing God in future. It's good to practice. There is a rumor, but he might be coming soon. So, in rehearsals. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah, to touch us all. Thank you.
assurance that you have given us. Then thank you for assuring us that, Lord, we can rest in you, knowing that all is well, because you are on the throne, Jehovah God. You gave us the victory even before we were. And this morning, Lord, we just want to bless you. We want to worship you, Jehovah God, for you deserve all the glory, Lord. There is none other than you who deserves our worship. And this morning, Lord, we have come to worship you. We have come to lift your name, Jehovah God.
And wealth, you humble and exalt, you raise the poor from the dust and lift the needy from the ash heap. You sit them with princes and have them inherit throne of honor. For the foundation of the earth are the Lord's. God, you set the world, and it cannot be shaken, and it cannot be moved. You will guard the feet of your faithful servants, and the wicked will be silenced in the place of darkness. Lord, we worship you. You are our strength. The wicked will not prevail. Those who oppose you, Lord, will be broken. You are the Most High, Lord. You will thunder from the heavens. Lord, you will judge the end of the earth according to the wicked and sinful act. You will give strength to those who trust in you. You will exalt the arm of the anointed. Father, we pray for anyone who is watching right now. Whatever need is in their heart, Father, may you reach, may you speak, may you touch, may you bring answers, may you bring comfort, may you bring peace to anyone who is in trouble, to anyone who is broken, to anyone who is hopeless, to anyone who has given up. We love you for our country, for the entire world, for what you are doing. Even as we continue to worship you, God, continue to move and speak to us in a different, in a specific way, personal way. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor, because you deserve the glory and the worship forever and ever. Amen. Praise Jesus.
Amen.
God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good, and that's his nature.
Thank you so much. Maybe you would like to give at this time. We welcome you for the time of giving. You can go on our Facebook page. You will see our paybill number for M-Pesa, and the bank account will be posted later. And we are so grateful and appreciate for those who continue to give their tithe and offering, also providing for those who are in need amongst us. So it's our time to listen from the Word of God. And today we have a servant of God, a man of God, anointed of God. Pastor Moses Ndungu is coming to bring the Word of God. Are you ready for the Word of God? Let us put our hands together to welcome a servant of God who is going to minister today the Word of God. kindly allow me to pray as he brings the word, the oracle of God. Our Heavenly Father, thank you. We are before you, want to eat our spiritual food. Father, will you kindly open our heart to receive? We pray for the Holy Spirit to minister to all of us today. We pray for the minister that the Holy Spirit will speak inside him so that we can be blessed. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Karibu, man of God.
Amen. And amen. Thank you, Pastor Meshach, and the worship team for leading us through a time of worship. Good to see each and every one of you right in your living rooms, and those of us who are here in the sanctuary as we continue with our worship of the Lord this beautiful, beautiful Sunday morning. Well, good morning and welcome to church right from wherever you are. I want to believe that the Lord has been good to you. The Lord has been gracious to you, and that you've continued to experience him in your life as an individual and even as a family. Turn with me to the book of Exodus, chapter number 14. Exodus chapter 14. We are going to read a couple of verses from Exodus chapter 14. If you are there, allow me to read. Then we are going to pray and share the word of the Lord. Then the Lord said to Moses, "Tell the Israelites to turn back and encamp near Pi Hahiroth, between Migdol and the sea. They are to encamp by the sea, directly opposite Baal Zephon." Verse 3. "Pharaoh will think the Israelites are wandering around the desert in confusion, hemmed by the desert. And I will harden Pharaoh's heart, and he will pursue them. But I will gain glory for myself through Pharaoh and all his army. And the Egyptians will know that I am the Lord." So the Israelites did exactly this. Verse 5. "Then the king of Egypt was told that the people had fled. Pharaoh and his officials changed their minds about them and said, 'What have we done? We have left the Israelites go and have lost their services.' So he had his chariot made ready and took his army with him. He took 600 of the best chariots along with all other chariots of Egypt, with officers over all of them. The Lord hardened the heart of Pharaoh, king of Egypt, so that he pursued the Israelites, who were marching out boldly." Verse 9. "The Egyptians, all Pharaoh's horses and chariots, horsemen and troops, pursued the Israelites and overtook them as they camped by the sea near Pi Hahiroth, opposite Baal Zephon. As Pharaoh approached, the Israelites looked up, and there were the Egyptians marching after them. They were terrified and cried out to the Lord. They said to Moses, 'Was it because there were no graves in Egypt that you brought us to the desert to die? What have you done to us by bringing us out of Egypt? Didn't we say to you in Egypt, leave us alone, leave us alone. Let us serve the Egyptians. It would have been better for us to serve the Egyptians than die in the desert.' Moses answered the people, 'Do not be afraid. Stand firm and you will see the deliverance the Lord will bring you today. The Egyptians you see today, you will never see again. the Lord will fight for you. You only need to be still. Let us jump to verse 21 of the same chapter, Exodus 14, verse 21. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and all that night the Lord drove back the sea with a strong east wind and turned it into dry land. The waters were divided, and the Israelites went through the sea on dry ground with a wall of water on their right and on their left. Verse 29. But the Israelites went through the sea on dry ground with a wall of water on their right and on their left. That day, the Lord saved Israel from the hands of the Egyptians, and Israel saw the Egyptians lying dead on the shore. And when the Israelites saw the great power the Lord displayed against the Egyptians, they feared the Lord and put their trust in him and in Moses, his servant. Lord, we bless you for your word today. As we divide it, I pray, Lord, that you minister to each and every one of us. Speak to me, speak through me, speak to all that are listening to your words this day. Lord, I pray that you give us an open heaven as we share, O God, that your purposes will be established over our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Well, today I want to bring us the word of God, titled, Nowhere to Run. Nowhere to Run. Free at last. Yahweh is great. Freedom has come. The Israelites will be heard chatting and beaming with smiles as they boldly march out of Egypt. Because you see, they had been set free. They had been released from slavery. They had been released from... They were on their way to the land of destiny. And you can almost hear them singing on that dusty desert path. Mwambie Farao, nimekombolewa, sitarudi tena Misri naenda Kanani. Mwambie Farao, nimekombolewa, sitarudi tena Misri naenda Kanani. It was a great day for the children of Israel, because the promise that God had given them, that one day I will deliver you. And the Lord himself was leading them, a pillar of cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night. So as they march out of Egypt, boldly smiling and rejoicing of what the Lord had done for them, the Lord led them into a valley towards the sea. And they were surrounded on their right and on their left by mountains. And in front of them was the sea. And if you ask anyone, this seemed to be a blunder. This seemed to be a stupid and an obvious mistake. Because in front of them, there is the sea. Nowhere to run, nowhere to go. On their sides, there were these mountains. The only way out was where they had come from. And I'm pretty sure they did not want to go back. And you can almost see some of the Israelites wondering aloud as they walk down this valley, what will happen if the Egyptians change their mind and come after us? we will have nowhere to run because there are mountains on either side and in front of us there is a sea. We are entrapped. We are entrapped, surrounded by mountains and the Red Sea in front of them. Well, their fears were confirmed. Pharaoh and his men did change their minds. Why did we release these guys? They were serving us. They were baking bricks. Who will do that for us now? It was free labor. Well, these questions, why did we release the Israelites, had at least 10 answers, and that is the 10 plagues. Friends, this was a very simple question because the hand of God had come heavily against the Egyptians and they released the children of Israel. But God had said, I will harden the heart of Pharaoh so that he will pursue the children of Israel. So the Israelites lifted up their eyes. And what do they see? They see dust rising in the horizon. Wait. Could that be a desert storm? But before they could even answer, their fears were confirmed. It was the mighty army of Pharaoh. They knew, kumekujwa, kimeumana. For our friends who don't speak Swahili, that is just the opposite of hakuna matata. Kujwa, kimeumana. Can you see them placing their hands on their head and saying, woi, 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 guy, fafa. Moza, Moza, what have you done to us? Mambo bad. Mambo, mambo bad. They were in an impossible situation. They were in a trap. There was no escape route because in front of them was the sea. On their sides, the mountains. Behind them was the mighty army of Pharaoh. They were at their most vulnerable. No weapons to fight. No training in combat. Maybe the weapons that the Israelites could have been carrying, maybe mwiko, you know, for making ugali and jembe. Because remember, these were slaves. They did not have any training in combat, nor did they carry any weapons to defend themselves. They were boxed in. And boy, oh boy, they turned to Moses. Why Moses? They even sang to him. Ewe Musa ulipo. No, 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 not that one that you're thinking. Not that one, not that one. I see people in the sanctuary, you need Jesus. This is my own composition. Ewe Musa uliko tutowa. Kule Misri maisha ilikuwa sawa. Kulikuwa makaburi mengi. Tuliweza hata kupata chakula. Oye, oye, tafadhali Musa. Enda sasa ongea na Fero. Sisi hapa nataka kufa hapa. Musa, and they were mad. They were mad at Moses. Why? Go talk to Pharaoh and let him not kill us. At least he can take us back. And I love the way Moses answered them. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God. The men of Israel had lost confidence in Moses' leadership. How could you lead us into a trap? And verse 11 This is what they said to Moses. They said to Moses, was it because there were no graves in Egypt that you brought us to the desert to die? What have you done to us by bringing us out of Egypt? Didn't we say to you in Egypt, leave us alone. Let us serve the Egyptians. It would have been better for us to serve the Egyptians than die in the desert. You know, they had lost their faith in God and they had forgotten what God had done for them. And many a times when we are boxed in, when there is nowhere to run, when there is no escape route, at times we lose our faith in God. But I love what Moses said to them. Do not be afraid. Can you imagine? The mightiest army in the world at that time is fast approaching on their chariots. And here Moses is telling the Israelites, do not be afraid. And I can only imagine the children of Israel asking Moses, what did you have for breakfast this morning? And Moses continues and tells them, stand firm and you will see the deliverance the Lord will bring to you today. The Egyptians you see today, you will never see again. The Lord will fight for you. You only need to be still. And the children of Israel were like, Moses, can't you see the reality? We are boxed in. We are going to die here. Can't you at least negotiate with Pharaoh? We go back. But the Bible clearly says that Pharaoh's intention was actually to take them back to Egypt for them to continue in the life of slavery. What am I to do when I am boxed in? What are you to do when you are boxed in? When you have no way out? When there is nowhere to run? What are you to do? The children of Israel, they panicked. They freaked out. And they turned their guns on their leader. Maybe you're there, you're saying, I am born again. I love the Lord and faithfully walks with him. Why am I in this situation? Does the Lord even care? Like the children of Israel, they were like, Moses, why did you lead us here? Well, if you read verse 1 of chapter 14, it is actually God who gave Moses those instructions. He told them, tell the children of Israel to turn back and let them camp near verse 2, they are to camp by the sea directly opposite Baal Zephro. It is actually the Lord who instructed Moses to tell the Israelites, let them turn back and let them camp, because God wanted them to experience him as their deliverer. The situation that you are in, friend, God wants to prove that he is God. You're there saying, why am I still single? Why am I not married? And yet I have served the Lord faithfully. And when I look at the years, they are counting. Or why is my marriage in a rocky place? Does the Lord care? I have this addiction and it seems just not to go away. I have tried counseling. I have tried even going to rehab. And I have no way out. Maybe you're a parent and you're saying, my children used to love the Lord, but now they no longer listen to me. They want nothing to do with the church. I have tried all that I can, and I am on the verge of giving up. What should I do? Friends, God is powerful. He made a way for the Israelites. He parted the sea, and he will do the same for you. This almighty, all-powerful God, just as he made a way for the Israelites and parted the sea so that they could walk on dry ground, he is the same God, and he will part the sea for you. He will make a way for you, even where there seems to be no way. What should you do? What should I do? You need to stop helping God. You need to stop helping God. He is God, and he knows the way out. His ways are not your ways. Allow God to be God. We need to stop trying to fix God. That God, this is the solution. Yet God knows what the solution could be. So this is what you should do. As we come to a close, turn with me to the book of Mark chapter 4. The gospel according to Mark and chapter number 4. This is what the Bible says. That day when evening came, Mark chapter 4 verse 35. That day when evening came, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us go over to the other side." Leaving the crowd behind him, they took him along just as he was in the boat. There were also other boats with him. Verse 37. A furious quail or storm came up, and the waves broke the boat so that it was nearly swamped. Jesus was in the stern, sleeping on a cushion. The disciples woke him up and said to him, "Teacher, don't you care that we are drowning?" Can you relate that with what the Israelites asked Moses when they were terrified? "Moses, don't you care that we are going to die in that desert?" The disciples of Jesus asked him, "Teacher, don't you care that we, if we drown?" And verse 39, and I love this verse. Jesus got up, rebuked the wind, and said to the waves, "Quiet, be still. Quiet, be still." Then the wind died down, and it was completely calm. This is what you should do. Be still. Be still. Allow God to part the sea for you. Allow God to make a way for you. You know, friends, the problem is we want to help God out. Well, I've got news for you. He doesn't need your help. Just be still and allow God to be God in whatever situation that you are boxed in. And verse 13 of Exodus 14, Moses knew something that the children of Israel did not know. Where God guides, he provides. Where God guides, he provides. If he guides you into a valley, he will provide for you in the valley. Where God guides, he makes a way. And this is the secret that Moses knew. Do not be afraid. Stand firm and you will see the deliverance the Lord will bring you today. And I'm here to encourage you, brother and sister. Do not be afraid. Stand firm and you will see the deliverance God will bring your way in that situation this very day. So where God guides, he provides. Where God guides, he makes a way out. If you want to guide yourself, be ready to provide for yourself. If you want to guide yourself, be ready to make a way for yourself. Imagine with me for a moment. when the Israelites were boxed in and they knew they could not go back towards the army of Pharaoh. Just imagine me for a moment. If somebody had said, let's go swimming, we can do this, imagine what would have happened to them. They would have drowned and died. And they would not have experienced the mighty deliverance of our God. Do not drown. Do not send yourself. When you have nowhere to run, be still. Don't help God. Allow him to be God. Do not go swimming. Don't go swimming. You will drown. Allow God to part the sea for you. Allow him to make a way even where there seems to be no way. And at this time, I'd like to invite the worship team. As I encourage you, just to reflect and think about your life. Are there situations that you are in? Is there a challenge in your life and you don't know where to go? You don't know whom to run to? I'm here to encourage you this morning. We serve a mighty God. Our God is all powerful and he will make a way even where there seem to be no way, because he is God. He is God and there is no any other God. So allow God to part the sea for you. Do not go swimming. You will drown. Allow God, because he says that my ways are not your ways. Trust in me. Trust in me. Not with some, but with all of your heart. Trust me with all of your heart. So as we sing this song, God will make a way. I want you to reflect and think about that situation. Maybe it is your finances. You're wondering, Lord, I even don't know where the next meal is going to come from. He will part the sea for you. He will make a way for you. Because he is God. He is God. And he will make a way for you. God will make a way.
God will make a way.
Yes, Lord.
Well, there seems to be no way.
Yes, Lord.
He works in ways we cannot see. He will make a way for me. He will be my God. Hold me closely to his side. We love and strive for each new day.
And that's who makes a way even where there seems to be no way. He is not governed by our situations. He is not a God who's governed by the seasons of our lives. He is God, and God the Almighty, and there is none like Him. Are you boxed in and you're wondering, Lord, whom do I run to? Where do I run to? I encourage you to say like the apostle Peter, whom else do we run to? Where else do we go apart from you, Lord? Because in you we find the bread of life. So we thank you, Lord. We thank you because you are a God who never changes. You tell us, Lord, in your word, that God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall in the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam and the mountain quake with their surging. There is a river whose stream make glad the city of God, the holy place where the Most High dwells. God is with her. She will not fall. God will help her at break of day. Nations are in uproar. Kingdoms fall. He lifts his voice. The earth melts. The Lord Almighty is with us. The Lord Almighty is with you. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Come and see the works of the Lord, the desolation he has brought on the earth. He makes war cease to the ends of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the shield with fire. Be still, and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob, the God of Israel, is our fortress. Lord, we are sorry for the many times we've lost faith in you, when we've been boxed in. And Lord, we turned to human solutions. We lost faith in you. We did not trust you. And yet, Lord, you had already figured it out. You already had a plan of how you are going to deliver us from that situation. But Lord, we chose to go swimming and we drowned. So this day we are coming back to you saying we are sorry, Lord. Forgive us and help us, Lord. Help us, Lord, to always trust in you, even when it doesn't make sense. For the Israelites, they were wondering, where else do we go? Who do we turn to? Yet, Lord, you knew that you were going to part the sea for them, and they were going to walk on dry ground. You are still a miracle working God. Maybe you are there and you're saying you've not even left Egypt. You are still in Egypt. You've not said yes to the Lordship of Jesus Christ. Won't you pray with me and accept the Lord as your Savior this day? Just say, Lord Jesus, I repent of my sins. Forgive me. From today, I accept you as my Lord and my Savior. I put my trust in you in all situations and circumstances. Amen. If you've made that prayer, you are born again. Welcome to the family of God. May the Lord bless you and keep you. And everyone, thank you for joining us. We hope to see you on Friday as we continue with our worship service. And next week on Sunday. God bless you and keep you. May His grace be sufficient in your life. Amen and amen.